Hello, and thank you so much for watching. My name is Allegra Garcia, and this video is all about my Aunt Beatrice Dominguez, who is the tango dancer in the Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse. Now, in today's video, I'm going to take you down to San Diego, where my Aunt Beatrice got her start as a dancer, in the 1915 Panama Pacific Exposition. While doing research, I found some pretty amazing information. In this video, I hope you'll enjoy a little bit of old California, along with some great history. Don't forget to click subscribe and ring the bell for all future videos. Enjoy. Today I'm in San Diego, California, at Balboa Park. Now today it's widely known to be a hot spot for wedding photos, sightseers, and tourists alike. In the past, San Diego has hosted two World's Fairs. The second fair was held in 1935, but the first fair was held back in 1915. Originally named City Park in 1868, City Park would later be named Balboa Park in 1910. For the Panama, California Exposition. The idea and planning for a World's Fair in San Diego was born after the completion of the Panama Canal. San Diego would be its first port, and many had hoped it would put San Diego on the international map and help to boost the economy. There were three different cities that wanted first dibs on hosting a World's Fair: New Orleans, San Francisco, and San Diego. Federal funding ultimately went to San Francisco, and rather than drop out, San Diego decided they would still proceed with their own fair in 1915. Now, both fairs were extremely successful, but San Francisco getting federal funding from Washington meant that they were the only ones who could use the word international in their title. But when San Francisco's fair ended, San Diego was so popular that it would be extended for another year. And in 1916, it would now be known as the San Diego International Exposition. Coming here today, it's as if you're stepping back in time. On most days, you can still find musicians and street performers performing in the plaza. The expo buildings were only expected to last temporarily. Many of the original buildings no longer exist. Many were redesigned for the 1935 expo. One building, still original to the 1915 Expo, still stands today. It's the California Building, and today it's the Museum of Man. There were many prominent families in San Diego involved with the creation of the exposition. Families such as Spreckles, Morstan, and the Scripps all played important roles with building the exposition. There were also many designers responsible for creating Balboa Park. The most prominent architect was Bertram Goodhue. He was the one who decided to bring the Spanish Colonial Revival style to San Diego. People loved Goodhue's idea. To them, it portrayed a romantic Spanish city on top of a hill. A way for information to be shared to other parts of the country and the world were with newsreels such as this. The Spanish troupe for the exposition was hugely popular due to Miss Ann Dare, Anne H.O. Davis, who would later become the vice president for Universal for Carl Laemmle. My Aunt Beatrice went by the name of La Bella Sevilla, and she was so popular that they used images of her on advertisements and brochures. On opening day, my Aunt Beatrice performed at the Cristobal Cafe, where only men were allowed. Sadly, it no longer exists, and today the Spanish village is located where it once stood. Thank you.
The village was originally constructed in 1935 for the second World's Fair. The buildings were built to resemble a quaint village in Spain with restaurants and boutique shops. Being only temporary, most of the buildings were demolished after the Exposition. But a group of artists got together and came in and saved it from completely being destroyed. They formed a community outreach and a place for the public to gather, in exchange to turn it into a working art studio. The artist colony acted as such until World War II, when the military used it for housing. After the war, it was reclaimed by the artists. It would be Miss Ann Dare and H.O. Davis who would lead the charge to bring in musicians, singers, and dancers to the exposition. To them, it was the finishing touch to bring out the spirit of Old Spain. The singing, playing, and dancing seemed to harmonize perfectly with the environment of the Spanish buildings and landscape.
Lo mejor, a mujeres no me falta ni el dinero ni el amor. Jineteando en mi caballo por la sierra yo me voy. Las estrellas y la luna ellas me dicen dónde voy. Ay, 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 mi amor. Ay, mi morena de mi corazón. Me gusta tocar guitarra. Me gusta cantar el son, mariachi me acompaña cuando canto mi canción. Me gusta tomar mis copas, aguardiente es lo mejor. También el tequila blanco con su sal le da sabor. Ay, 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 mi amor. Ay, mi morena de mi corazón. Me gusta tocar guitarra, me gusta cantar el son. El mariachi me acompaña cuando canto mi canción. Me gusta tomar mis copas, aguardiente es lo mejor. También el tequila blanco con su sal le da sabor. Ay, 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 mi amor. Ay, mi morena de mi corazón. Ay, 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 mi amor. Ay, mi morena de mi corazón.
The botanical building was intended to house exotic plants not native to California for the public to see. The idea of a reflecting pond was to capture both the skyline and the beautiful architecture, so in a way it looked like a portrait of itself. I love that story because growing up this portrait of my Aunt Beatrice hung inside of my Nana's house. Now, I was always led to believe years after she died that this was taken in Los Angeles. But after doing research, I found that it was more than likely taken right here in Balboa Park. I can't wait to see what everything looks like after they finish with the renovations. There's something so fascinating to me about visiting the same places where my ancestors once walked. It's like I get a step back in time and get a little taste of what their lives must have been like. when film production companies moved out west from the East Coast to get away from Edison's motion picture patents and take advantage of the great location and almost year-round sunshine, San Diego quickly became a favorite spot for films to shoot. Stars such as Wallace Reid, Murray Pickford, Fatty Arbuckle, and even Rudolph Valentino, who would later dance the tango with my Aunt Beatrice. They all shot movies here. Also included on this list was this famous swashbuckler, Douglas Fairbanks Sr. Fairbanks used the exteriors of the Exposition for his 1916 film, The Americana. It's one of the first times my Aunt Beatrice would perform on film, and this footage, along with the tango scene in The Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse, sadly, are all that's known to exist. Another amazing landmark that still stands from the 1915 Expo is this magnificent Morton Bay fig tree. I love how beautiful and grand it is, its deep roots representing all of the generations that have passed through here, its leaves and branches representing stories of those who have passed. In a way, it's like this tree watches over Balboa Park, protecting it so that the new generations can hear their stories. I would like to do a quick land acknowledgement to the Kumeyaay tribe, for they are the original caretakers of this land. I also want to say a thank you to my Aunt Inez, who was the sister of my Aunt Beatrice. My Aunt Inez was the one who saved what records I do have of the Dominguez family.